Okay, I know I have some younger viewers, so I'm warning you now. I think this video, no, actually, I know this video will be dirty and sexual, so. Hey guys, it's Megan, and I thought it'd be super cool to read One Direction fanfiction. A lot of popular YouTubers do a video on like reading their fanfiction. They read like fanfictions that fans have wrote about them or whatever. I hope there's no fanfiction out there about me. I don't really know. I've never actually searched for it. I hope there's not. So since I'm hoping there's no fanfictions about me, I thought it'd be even funnier and better to do some One Direction fanfictions because we know there are literally millions and millions of One Direction fanfictions out there. So I asked you guys on Twitter to tweet me links to some One Direction fanfictions, and I'm just going to read some of them for you guys. Holy crap! These are literally like books. I don't know if you guys know this or not, but like I don't read books. This literally has 41 chapters. 41! I can't read this much on camera. I don't want to make like a 72-hour long video. This one is called That One Text. So I'm gonna try to get like the basics of it without reading the whole thing. Anna Shay is a normal 18-year-old girl who lives in London. She shares a small flat with her best friend Elka. These best friends have been through everything together from the beginning. They are there for each other when needed. Anna has a job at a sweets store while Elka has one at the shoe store in the same plaza. Kinda sounds like me and Kinsey in a way, because me and Kinsey would live together and we'd both work in a mall. That seems like us. They both can drive, though they don't have a car due to college expenses. Literally me. Literally me. Anna's whole life changes when she finds an iPhone on the floor in the store she walks in. Oh snap. Who does this phone belong to? The one and only Louis Tomlinson from One Direction. She decides to keep this from Elka, and her life is an adventure from there. Oh my gosh, that sounds actually really interesting. But there's no way I'm reading all 42 chapters, so. Okay, I'm just gonna skip to the very last chapter and see what kind of happens in chapter 41. If you actually are reading this fanfiction, then I want to apologize because I do not want to ruin it for you, but in my sake, I'm not gonna read all 40-something chapters, so I'm going to spoil it for myself, because why not? He stood up from his seat and went towards the bed I was on. Anna, you're finally awake, Niall said. I need to see Zayn, I ignored his statement. Okay, I would not ignore Niall, but whatever. That's when I lost it. I raised my fist and aimed below his belt. He immediately groaned in pain. Okay, so Anna just literally kicked Niall in the balls just so she could go see Zayn. Really, I'm confused. I don't know why she's in a hospital, and I don't know why she wants to go see Zayn. I quickly answered him by pressing my lips against his. And I've missed this so much. This time it was different. The kiss. It was real. It was something we both wanted. It was something that showed our love for one another. I love Zayn. I will link all these fanfictions down below in case you want to go read them for yourself, because this actually seems really good. Okay, this seems like a shorter one, so I'm gonna try to read this one. This is called Twitter Hate. I just kept reading the tweets, looking for hate. Liam, being my best friend, keeps telling me to stop, but I still do it. Some of the tweets are horrible. I kept reading them. I felt tears streaming down my face. Liam walks in, takes one look off of my face. He sits next to me on the bed and reads the tweets from my iPhone 5. She says, please stop reading the stupid tweets. Anyone who does that is not a true fan, I said. What if they are right, Liam? Liam asked. What do you mean? I said. It's nothing. Liam doesn't know this, but I'm gay and in love with him. Plot twist! Liam says, let me see your arms again. He know I cut my arms because of the hate. He doesn't know I cut my stomach because I know he will never love me as I love him. I rolled up my sleeves. He saw the old cuts from a few months ago and ones that were recent from a few hours ago. Okay, I actually don't even want to read any more of this one. That's something I never really thought of. Like, I know they get so much love on Twitter, but have you ever thought about like them reading just through hate comments on Twitter and like getting upset about it? Just picturing Niall cutting himself is heartbreaking. It's literally heartbreaking. Okay, I'm going on to the next one. Last one, but this one is called Dirty Diary, and then in parentheses it says sixsome. So basically you're having sex with all five of One Direction. You were chilling in your room, bored out of your mind. So you decide to sort out your things. Suddenly you come across a little brown box. You open it up to see your One Direction posters and your diary. You used to write dirty One Direction fantasies in your diary. You smile at it, remembering your Directioner days, when all of a sudden an arm reaches over your shoulder and grabs a bunch of your posters. Louis, give them back, you yell, chasing after him into the living room with Niall, Zayn, Liam, and Harry sitting in. Harry looks at you with lust in his eyes. as he slowly walks over to you while taking off his shirt. Suddenly, he lays on top of you, starting a heated makeout session. Zane reads this as he looks over at Harry, who is already shirtless on his way over to you. Oh my god. So apparently, they have her diary and they're reading through all her dirty imagines that she wrote down when she was younger, and they're making them come true. Just then, you feel Niall's big warm hands lifting up your top over your head, and Harry's mouth traveling down towards your oh my god. You squeeze your lips together, trying to hold back your moan, but Liam comes down to your face. It's okay, babe. Moan all you want. Harry's fingers are soon joined by Niall's as they gently slide into you, making your moans even louder. Just then, Now lifts you up and puts you on all fours, slamming his... As Harry takes the front, not giving you any time to adjust, Louis puts himself back in your mouth, again going faster than... I am done.
I didn't even get to the worst part. It was so great that we got to end it on that note. I'm so proud that it got to that point. Okay guys, well that was my attempt at reading some One Direction fan fiction. It got a little dirty at the end, so I apologize for that. I did warn you at the beginning of the video, so. If you guys like this video, please give it a thumbs up, and if you would like a part 2, 3, 4, 5, 7, 9, what I'm trying to say is if you want more videos like this, then tell me down in the comments down below. Again, I will link down all of the fanfictions I used down below, but I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, give it a thumbs up, and I will see you guys in my next video. Bye!